Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to my channel. My name is Ness. In this video, I'm gonna do a quick comparison and review on these three iconic models from Vans. The first one is the Vans Authentic. The second one is the Vans Old School. And also the third one is the Vans Slip On. And as usual, I'm gonna share with you guys my six different looks based on these three iconic models. Let's go. So let's go to the first shoes. I'm gonna go with the earliest release to the latest release on these three shoes. The first one is the Vans Authentic. The construction wise, they used the vulcanized construction, very typical traditional craftsmanship for footwear back then, you know, during the 60s, 70s. Look at the Jux Taylor. They basically have the same construction, which is a little bit different aesthetic, but the base foundation is this vulcanized rubber on the tooling. The cushioning on the insole, the same on across these three models. And also the 1976, they start to debut the text of the wall, all across Van shoes of the wall text in red. And these shoes, I have a lot of memory with this, you know, when I was a dancer, break dancing on the string and also on the street. This is one of the shoes that to go, especially when I expect that I'm gonna dance on the street on concrete, then I would wear Vans Authentic to dance with it. The reason why is Vans Authentic was very affordable back then, you know. I can find a pair of Vans Authentic for $45 to like $40. And you know, if you dance on concrete, your shoes break out really fast, especially around this toe area in the lateral side, my pinky toe. I always have a hole there, and also where's my flex point at on the rubberized foxing. And the outsole on this is very sticky, you know, very good for dancing. I really love this outsole tooling, but to me, like, they are for fashion as well, not just for skateboarding. And you see a lot of other designer brand, they copy, they inspire from Vans, you know, aesthetic. So let's go into the second model. Is the Vans Old School. I think this one is always more popular than the Vans Authentic for these last 10 years. You know, see a lot of people, a lot of K-pop star, they wear Vans shoe, specifically Vans Old School. I think this model is just iconic, you know, very clean, very nice. It feels a little bit more premium compared to the Vans Authentic and Vans Era because they have suede, which is make a little bit more premium. And the most iconic detail on this Vans Old School, not just the material, they also have the jazz stripe on the side of the shoe. The shoes is much more feel like a premium product compared to the Vans Authentic. And also, like, the Vans Authentic only cost like $60 for the retail price. This one is a little bit more expensive. It's like 10 bucks, you know, $70. But this one is feel a little bit more premium because they have leather suede as well as the padded color and the padded tongue slightly. You feel a little bit more comfortable compared to the Vans Authentic. When they add this leather, they also increase the durability on a pair of shoe. And the construction wise on these shoes is basically the same as the Vans Authentic. It's the vulcanized rubber with the Vans of the wall text in red. And also is the iconic waffle outsole. I never really dance on this Vans Old School. I just wear it for more like a lifestyle. I remember I own a pair of this black colorways exactly like this, and the second one was in red colors. I think those two colors is my two favorite color. And go to the last shoes that I'm gonna do comparison with, which is this Vans Slip On Checkerboard. I don't have experience with this pair of slip-on shoes. I mean slip-on shoes in general, because I don't really like the shoes that without laces. However though, when I try the shoes on, styling with these shoes, I feel like it's growing me, you know, especially the checkerboard. This is so iconic. It's very easy on and off, you know, very convenient. And they have padded around the collar. And the construction wise, the material wise, they basically use the same, which is the DNA from Vans, is the material canvas and also the vulcanized rubber in the tooling. And in the back, they have Vans of the wall tags in red. Waffle also, and this slip-on shoes was released on the 1977, which is the same year when they released this Vans Old School. And this model slip-on shoes is the original slip-on design that influenced for many slip-on shoes after, and this cost $65, so it's $5 extra from this Vans Authentic and $5 less on this Vans Old School. Styling with these shoes, I think they are very basic style. You know, you don't have to go crazy or go super stylish on your clothes with this pair of Vans. You can wear like a normal, just a blue jeans, white tee, already look good with this all three shoes, you know. These all three shoes, they, yes, they are different design, but they are the same style. You can wear with anything with this or three iconic pair of Vans. So the sizing wise, all the shoes though, they fit basically two size. Comfort wise, I feel like they're all the same, you know, because they use the same insole and the same construction. So you may feel like a little bit more snug fit on the slip on, because I get it, without lace, you have to have more like secure, you know, snug fit on the upper of the shoe. They basically just have the elastic band at the side. And I'm just wondering, how do they keep the price that low, you know? Very nice design, very unique, and also very iconic classic shoes from across the world, not just in the state. And up next, I'm gonna share with you guys how I would like to style them. Thank you. So there you have it. This is my quick review and comparisons on these three iconic Vans shoe, the authentic Vans, old school Vans, and the slip-on Vans. And if you like one of the look in this sick look that I create with these three iconic model from Vans, comment below in the comment sections. And if you like one of the look in this video, give me a thumb up and subscribe to my channel for more video. I have a lot of video coming up every single week, and I can't wait to share with you guys. I'm out.